a family where nothing works. Uh-huh. Eh? Yes. But it will work for you.
Amen.
Because what I'm seeing is where you're coming from, nothing they work there. Hey! Eh? And it looks as if you are the only small light where they shine, small.
Yes, yes.
Eh?
Yes.
Eh?
Yes.
Just small. Small. But now it will shine holistically.
Amen! Thank you, Jesus.
Because what God is showing me is, I am seeing Nigerian flag in your hand. And I see you very close to a particular politician.
Uh-huh.
Eh?
Yes.
You are close to a politician.
Yes.
Eh?
Yes,
yes. Very, very close.
Yes.
Eh?
Yes. Good. Enter deeper, mommy. Professor. Can you just jump those hands together for Jesus? Celebrate the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords.
See, don't glory yet for him.
Professor, mommy.
There's something I said last week. I said, Queen's English does not eliminate mouth odor.
That's right.
It's possible to be in the midst of plenty, yet in scarcity.
I hear you, mommy.
I've seen people bagging big portfolio, but nothing to show. As a result of where they are coming from.
Kai.
Sir, it's not by working closely to a politician. Eh?
Mm.
What we want is.
That's right.
If I don't pray for you,
pray for him, mommy.
You got to answer him by mouth.
Kai.
But nothing to show.
Mm. Help him, mommy.
Because I see something like Edo.
Yes, I work with the governor of Edo State.
Hey! Can you jam your hands together for Jesus? The oracle of God. The eagle eye of the Lord. Prophesy they go, mommy.
I didn't go pray for you.
Pray for him, mommy.
Because I saw you with that flag. But I saw a man came and collected that flag.
For my God. Cha.
But I want to give you the bigger flag.
Are you just looking like that?
I see you in front of ambulance.
Okay, listen
is
to
somebody
mommy.
Sick around you?
Yes. I'm induced coma right now.
Your elder brother is in coma.
Yeah.
Right
he had,
now.
He had plastic surgery yesterday.
He had plastic surgery.
Yesterday.
Yesterday.
Yes.
Car.
Now wow.
Power.
I just saw this one now.
The eagle eyes of the Lord.
Somebody's in coma. Yes. Your elder brother.
Yes.
I see you in front of ambulance.
Mm.
And I'm seeing obituary poster in front of. Is it bonnet they call it? Is it bonnet? Bonnet, on the bonnet. I'm seeing something. Is it Sunday?
Sunday.
His name is Sunday.
Pastor Sunday.
Pastor.
Yes.
He's a pastor.
Yes.
We need to pray for him.
Kai, pray for him, mommy.
Because I see him. Near my ambulance, huh?
Kai.
I see where he was crying. And I see a man inside casket being conveyed.
My God.
You know? How many surgery?
Yes.
Eh?
Yes, ma'am.
No. I see him gone.
Happy mommy.
Don't get me a bottle of anointing on your own.
Thank you, Jesus.
No.
Can you jump your hands together for Jesus? Celebrate Jesus. The voice of solution. Thank you, mommy.
You are married, Abby?
Yes, ma'am.
Eh?
Yes, ma'am.
But your life is likened unto one who is not married.
Hey! Child, prophesy, mommy. Enter deeper.
Because I'm seeing a disparity. Huge spiritual demarcation.
My God.
Eh?
Yes, ma'am.
Spiritually, physically. Eh? Because I see this is like no verse from you. Eh?
No, ma'am.
Woman, hey, God help me.
Professor, mommy, unveiling the veil.
He's in Lagos.
Yes, ma'am.
And you are here.
Yes, ma'am.
For how long?
And since he came back to Nigeria, and
since he came back to Nigeria,
that was 2017.
Since 2017.
Yes, ma'am.
He has been in Lagos. Come on, neighbor.
Yes.
Ha!
My God.
This prophecy is heavy. Let me not say this.
because this is like his face this way. Even if you are talking, you know, but your face this way, his face this way. So whether you like him, you love him as a husband, but there are things occupying you and there are things occupying him.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Emotionally. We need to do something about this. So that if you are married, let's know you are married.
That's right.
If not, a lot of things will go wrong. Because I see you occupied, him occupied. This one has no spiritual connotation. Yes. It's a matter of understanding and agreement. Because you man don't know what's going to happen there. Him don't know what's going to happen here. A lot of things are going wrong.
My God.
Which are not supposed to. A lot. And if time is not taken, there is something I see between now and February next year that will bring about separation. Compulsory one.
My God.
But the Lord said I should put an end to it.
Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Can you just jump those hands together for Jesus?
Put an end to it.
Hallelujah.
That is if you are interested for me to put an end to it.
Okay.
Because if I don't, February, there will be separation.
Madam, listen to mommy.
And the Lord said, stop it before it's too late. I need to pray for you.
Pray for her, mommy.
Because I'm seeing something like this, like a tana snamadi wolo fukuranya. Eh? Like one eye. And that one eye na daughter. Are you listening to me?
Madam, listen to mommy.
I'm listening.
And that one eye na waiting.
Daughter.
Eh?
Daughter.
Eh?
Daughter.
Eh?
Daughter.
Because I see you looking for somebody.
That is my daughter.
Where is she?
Power. Power.
Where is she?
She's my sister-in-law.
Eh?
She's my sister-in-law.
When last did you see her?
10 years.
10 years ago.
Power, lady powder. Enter deeper, mommy. Professor.
Because what I'm seeing is... Your sister-in-law,
yes.
But you never see him.
I never.
Why you never see him?
Refuse me to see her.
Eh?
She refused me to see her.
What I'm seeing is not far from where we are now.
She stays in Kubwa.
Eh?
She stays in Kubwa.
She stays in Abuja here.
Yes, ma'am.
And you've not seen her for 10 years.
Yes, ma'am.
Authority of God, who Professor,
is,
mommy.
Who is Patricia?
My sister-in-law.
Your sister-in-law.
Yes.
Hey, can you jam those hands together for Jesus?
There was a time you attempted suicide.
Twice.
And you are still contemplating it.
My sister brought me here.
Okay, you know her? This woman won't kill herself. Are you aware?
Yes.
Are you aware?
Yes, ma'am.
That she wants to kill herself.
Yes, ma'am.
She wants to take her own life.
Yes, ma'am.
Because you are the one that brought her.
Yes, ma'am.
Her husband's people don't like her.
Hey!
Eh?
Yes, ma'am.
They even want the man marry another wife.
Yes, ma'am.
You are here. I don't want to go. Professor, mommy.
Because I see where she's frustrated. And she said if she don't see her picking between now and December, says she must die.
Kai!
Mommy, you are there. You are there.
Yeah, why are not going to
die? Authority of God. Professor, mommy.
But listen.
Madam, listen to mommy.
You are going to see your daughter.
Amen.
Madam, listen. I'm going to give you a date.
Thank you, mommy.
Are you listening to me?
Yes.
Your daughter will call you and both of you go see.
Amen. Can you jam your hands together for Jesus? Celebrate Jesus. Celebrate Jesus. Oracle of God.
Don't ever think of killing yourself.
Uh-huh.
Eh? Because you go see your daughter, the thing where they went, they carry off her eye go drop.
Amen.
And her eyes go clear.
Amen.
She will start looking for you.
Amen.
Thank you, Jesus.
First of all, I see, you don't grow.
Yes.
Then how would they stop her from seeing her mother?
The the voice of solution. People of God, can you jump
to Jesus?
5 years in marriage, no child. I say, baby, do not say give patience.
Thank you, Jesus. Can you jump those hands together for Jesus? Celebrate Jesus.
Wait. Gombe. What does he mean?
I'm from Gombe, ma.
You are from Gombe.
Prophesy, mommy.
You are from Gombe.
Yes, ma. I'm coming from Gombe. Eh? From
you are Gombe. Coming from Gombe.
Yes.
Then what am I seeing in Enugu?
My husband is from Enugu.
Your husband is from Enugu?
Yes, ma.
Oracle of God. Prophesy, they go, mommy. Enter deeper.
Your husband is from Enugu?
Yes, ma.
Then you are Gombe.
Yes, ma. Hey.
Ah. Is it Gombe or Gombe?
Gombe State, ma. Gombe.
Somebody say Gombe. Gombe. I need to pray for you.
Pray for her, mommy.
Because I see a baby boy coming.
Ha. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
Are you listening to me? Don't cry.
Yes, ma'am.
I need to pray for you.
Pray for her, mommy.
Because what God is showing me is, I'm seeing something like, it's like palm tree.
Mm.
Now I went along. Eh? Now that place, your womb there.
My God.
They hung your womb there.
Hey!
A certain woman. Are you listening to me?
Madam, listen to me.
Carried your womb and hung it.
Hey!
On a palm tree.
My God.
He said, patience.
Mm.
You cannot have a child.
Car.
For John. Yes, John. Who
yes,
be John?
My husband.
Your husband is John.
Yes.
Can you jam those hands together for Jesus? Celebrate Jesus. Celebrate Jesus. Car.
But the Lord said, the yoke is broken.
Yeah. Amen.
I don't know what you are looking for.
Yes, Lord.
I don't know what you anticipate.
Yes, Lord.
I don't know what you're asking God for.
Uh-huh.
Between now and the next 1 week.
Yes, Lord.
If your amen is not, it shall enter your hand.
Amen. Thank you, Jesus.
Sit on the head of your enemy.
Thank you, mommy.
Immediately you did your hand like this.
Uh-huh.
I see you doing what I'm doing.
Mm.
I see you preaching.
I'm a pastor.
You are a pastor.
Yes, ma'am.
You a pastor.
Yes.
You are a pastor.
Yes.
Sunlight gathering,
yes,
assembly,
yes,
but things are not the way they are supposed to
be. That's true,
eh?
That's right. Yes.
I saw somebody carry sand from there.
Hey,
yes,
somebody carry sand from there.
Uh-huh.
I went to the middle of the road,
uh-huh,
and this was an assembly around Delta State.
Hey,
you are from Delta State.
Yes.
The person mentioned the name 7 times. Promise, will be promise.
It's me,
you are promise. Yeah.
Prophesy, mommy. Jump your hands together for Jesus.
He said, I will make sure you return to the village and farm with us.
God. My God. Help me, mommy.
Since that time till now, everything is going down. Eh? Talking
true.
About this coat where you wear.
That's true.
You, God, and I know things are not the way they are supposed to.
That's true.
When you pray for people, they get results.
Exactly.
But when they want, if when it's time for remembrance, they go to another church.
Exactly.
And give testimony.
Exactly.
And pay their tithes.
Exactly.
And give their seedings.
You are right.
And their offerings.
You are right.
Hey! The oracle of God. The eagle eyes of the Lord.
But listen.
Uh-huh.
Today marks the end of that affliction.
Yeah. God, you celebrate Jesus. Celebrate Jesus. Celebrate Jesus. Cha.
Listen to me.
Okay, listen to mommy.
Listen and eh?
I believe you.
You believe me?
Yes.
Authority of the Lord.
This is not past God. He no past God. Nothing. Nothing past God. Call me to answer.
You are a seer.
I am a seer.
Yes.
That is why they make me see. I go impart them inside you now. There is grace. There are graces, but there is grace that graces grace.
That's true.
Power.
Are you listening to me?
Okay, listen to mommy.
But I'm going to impart something into you now.
Hallelujah.
That you will never forget for the rest of your life.
Amen.
Your ministry is about to be announced globally.
Thank you, Jesus.
Let God use me to help your life.
Uh-huh. Thank you, Jesus.
I am going to use this mantle.
Uh-huh.
Immediately you touch it,
uh-huh,
something will carry you.
My God.
And that will be the beginning of a change of story.
Hallelujah.
Now you're going to touch this.
Uh-huh.
Immediately you touch it, something will carry you. Are you listening to me?
And your ministry is going to have a new face. That even people that mocked you before will begin to look and how.
Hallelujah.
When you started building,
That's my wife.
That's your wife. The problem of this man started the day he said he won't put block.
You are right
for village.
You are right, ma.
Professor, mommy.
You know him? Okay. See, he used to do well before.
Yes, ma. Yes, ma.
This man, he don't touch money. But now it is a struggle.
Yes, ma. Yes, ma.
Somebody went to the place he was building.
Mm.
And buried charm there.
My God.
Now he suffers so much now.
Yes,
but
ma.
He used to have money before.
Yes, ma.
I have seen some things inside that pot.
Mm.
I've seen them like red oil. In as much as you eat oil, say you be poor.
My God. God. Help me, mommy.
Buried it in that place. And the person mentioned the name, Christian.
That is his name.
You are Christian?
That's my name.
God! Professor, you go, mommy!
Because they carry all you do that thing in your name, Christian. And I see this around Anambra.
I'm from Anambra.
You are from Anambra.
Can you jump those hands together for Jesus? Professor, you go, mommy. Enter deeper.
So, as the man do the thing with oil, red oil, for that place where you debuted, you come to eat food where they carry all you cook.
My God.
And then as much as you keep eating food that is being cooked with oil, you will keep going poor and poorer, poorer, poorer. But I'm going to spoil it now.
Amen. Thank you, Jesus.
If he was the one that made oil, let it where it do work. Let it continue to work.
That's right.
But if he's not the one that created palm oil, any day he may go eat palm oil,
He
will die.
Thank you.
I say he shall die.
Power.
Sit on the head of your name.
Thank you, mommy.
Inside your heart, you be the pray. Yes. Say, oh God, use her to locate me. Eh?
I came from a far place.
From a far place. He said, look, use her to locate me. I don't want to go like this. I don't want to go empty-handed. I don't want to live here without this woman talking to me. That's what you are praying in your heart. Stop crying. Do you know him?
No. No.
You don't know him. But is there anything that is familiar that he's wearing? Wait. Let me see. What's that?
I'm a soldier.
You're a soldier?
Yes, ma'am.
Oracle of God! Can you jam your hands together for Jesus? Power!
I want to tell you what you will understand. Do you know thatched house? This old thatched house? Mud house?
Yes, ma'am.
Olaja?
Yes, ma'am.
Nobody will be say people they live inside. Very small. Hot.
Yes, ma'am.
Now that place you stay in the realm of the spirit. A woman put you there and locked you.
My God.
Inside.
Hey!
And I saw where you were stranded. The person collected something from you, and this thing has to do with paper. Paper. Yeah?
Yes, ma'am.
It has to do with paper. And that paper has to do with education.
Yes, ma'am.
What is supposed to be given you? Is being given to another.
Exactly.
Exactly. Including rank.
Exactly.
Position.
Exactly, ma'am.
God,
help me.
Because this is, you have been in it for many years. Oh.
16 years plus.
16 years plus. My but God. Nothing to show.
Just a copra, man. Even
just a copra. But you, because I see you as a graduate.
I'm a graduate, man.
You're a graduate.
Even, man.
Kai! Help me, mommy. My God.
We shall not be forsaken. John.
John, it's my name, man.
You are John?
Yes, ma'am.
Sit down and see me after service. Let's settle it.
Please, can we still celebrate the King of Kings? Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. I promised two widows last week.
That's right.
One widow had an accident. KK accident.
That's right.
And she has two kids. Okay, is that you? I promise you 300,000.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
This is 300K. Of my love for the poor.
That's right. Thank you, Jesus.
This is now this reason. Eh? Now God give me gift. That's just it. I have realized it. Until you discover, you cannot recover.
That's right.
So now this discovery, now it make the gift still the flow as it the flow. So any gift you have that cannot benefit your generation, our honorable gift, that cannot benefit the poor, is not of God. I must do what the Lord said I should do. If I remove giving from my ministry, this is my calling. Any day I have not helped somebody, that day is not fulfilling for me. You just say pure water.
Yes, ma'am.
And a pure water, they carry the train children. Sponsor yourself.
Yes, ma'am.
Pure water, sachet water.
God.
What a life.
My God.
Madam, take this 300,000.
Can you just appreciate the King of
from today?
Aha.
I don't want you to hawk pure water.
Thank you, Jesus.
The hawk what pure water, 5 naira. Na gari na wo. 10 naira, na gari na wo. That's all. And the thing can they give you migraine. No more. Go and start your business.
Hallelujah.
Congratulations.
Can you celebrate the King of Kings? Celebrate the God of this great commission.
Rosemary from Kogi State. I thank God when I come to this church. As he called me out, I was surprised. He came to me. It was when mommy do it, I see this canoe. I know the Lord has to withstand me with my three children. I'm hawking pure water so that I can maintain my children. As mommy to train my children. As mommy locate me, he tell me to stop everything, that everything is over. I'm going to bring my children from village to come and stay with me, to go to school at Abuja. I believe what mommy has said, and it has come to pass today. I give glory to God and more long life and prosperity and grace upon his ministry. And I thank God what mommy has done for me has made my life to change. And I have seen physically that my life has changed from this moment. Mommy has located me. I return of the glory to God. The Lord reward him. And more the glory will follow him. No evil will stop him on the way. More anointing and more grace will follow him and his family.
Madam, you come. The giving is advancing. Yes, your husband.
He's dead.
You're a widow.
Yes.
How many children do you have?
Two.
Two children.
Yes.
What happened to your leg when they work like this?
It's keke accident.
Keke accident.
Yes, ma'am.
Keke na pep.
My God. God.
Jesus. And you see. Eh? Now your lap be this.
Yes.
Now you chop up like this.
Yes, ma'am.
Now your lap chop like this.
Yes, the hand, this particular hand.
And you are a widow.
Yes,
they stay?
Guagua.
Guagua. What do you want me to do for you?
A business.
Business.
Yes, food stuff business.
Come and collect 300,000.
Hey! Can you celebrate Jesus? Kai.
Mommy, God will bless you. Shall be well with you. Shall be well with your husband. Shall be well with your children forever and ever.
Amen.
Mommy, you have removed shame from me. People mock at me after the accident that I used to do like this when I was with money. Mommy, I've suffered a lot. No food, no nothing. But only God will bless you. Long life for you and your family.
Can you join your hands together for Jesus?
It is well with you.
Amen.
Arise. Arise now.
My name is Joseph Egaite Sonde. I'm from Akwa Ibom State, in the village of Ibionigo, in the local government. I'm a living witness that when I came to this church, somebody brought me to this church. The person saw me stranded. I was begging by the roadside before I eat. Somebody brought me to this church. He said if I come here, mommy would know the reason of my accident. That is what the person told me. I said I'll come to that church. Because since I have this accident, nobody has ever told me. They would say, it shall be well, it shall be well. So I came to this church. Mommy sees me. God has been using mommy in a very good way for me, for prayer. This time she saw me, she would pray for me. So when my husband died, I suffered a lot. People just helped me. Little by little, I suffered a lot, so it was a problem. All the money has been squandered in the hospital. But I thank God, as I come to this mommy place, mommy locates me on Tuesday. I was just standing when mommy called. One woman at my back said, am I the one? Mommy said, no. He said, you, madam, come. When I come forward, I was confused because I couldn't expect. God used mommy right there for me. And she gave me this 300,000 naira. It's real. This is the money. She gave me cash. Mommy gave me this money real for me to go and use it and run a business for me and my children. Most of the time we stay at home. No food, no water. I was living a life of begging. I would go to Lifetime and beg. But today, God used mommy. Mommy rose getting to end the insult in my life and in my family. And I stand here to say God will bless her. God will bless her husband. God will bless her generation. Her children will not be put to shame. What we are facing as widows, the entire of our family will not face it in Jesus' name. Now that mommy has given me this money, I would use this money to start a good business for my life. Because house is a problem to me. Many things is a problem to me. Look at my leg. Because of the accident, everything has gone wrong in my life. But today, God has established a new life into my family and I in Jesus' name. Amen.
Casey, come here. You're my son. My real son. Don't be saying a far away son, real son.
That's right.
Is your wife at home? Your wife is here?
Yes,
where
ma'am.
Is she? This is what the Lord said I should do for you. I never thought of this. As a matter of fact, this revelation came last night. I didn't discuss this with you. You don't even know, say I want to do this thing. But what thing I want to do now? This is what you've been trying to do for many years and you couldn't do. You've been trying to do this for many years. You couldn't scale through. But the Lord said, I should help you to arrive early.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
Uh-oh,
old is this relationship?
Mommy.
Eh? 7. 7 years.
Yes, ma'am.
There is something not right. Eh?
Yes, ma'am.
Eh?
Yes, ma'am.
And this thing has been, you have been praying to God. You say, God, this shame is too much. Eh?
Yes, ma'am.
This is like diary not paid. For 7 years. Eh?
Yes, ma'am.
And it has been bringing issues.
Yes.
Between your people and him.
Yes.
Eh?
Yes.
No, besides this man, no love you. He love you.
Eh? Yes, I know.
But anytime when he try, make he gather money, go do something. Yes. Eh? The thing goes scatter.
Yes.
Eh?
Yes.
No be once. No be twice.
Yes.
No be thrice. Eh?
Yes, ma.
He go gather money, gather money. Mm. Say, so let me go do something on this woman's head because I love this woman where they produce these fine children for me.
God.
Anytime when he try to make the move, something go happen.
My God.
The money go scatter. Casey, no be so you no man do a mo. Eh? But the money to go do one, no problem.
Honestly, mommy,
eh?
You are right.
You go try. You go fail. You go try. Reach to that before you know, the money go scatter. How much is it? How much?
320,000.
320,000 for 7 years. October. First week of October. You will go and do something. Pay everything in full.
Hallelujah. Anamaka.
This is 500,000.
Thank you, Jesus. Can you celebrate Jesus? Can you celebrate Jesus?
This is 500K. The money at 320. This is 500,000. Go and pay everything in full. Go and tell your in-laws. Say you be man.
Hey! Hey!
Right. I want you to show them. Okay. Are you supposed to be? Because they don't value you because of this thing. Eh?
You are right, ma'am.
Eh?
You are right.
They don't value you.
Honestly. You are right, ma'am.
They know your papa in law don't value you.
Honestly.
Your in-laws don't value you.
Honestly. He go no.
He said something. He said what?
Make my God bless you too.
What does this man know? He said thank you, ma. Chai. Casey. Go and show them they work. Can't work a girl.
Thank you, Jesus.
It's not as if you are not trying. The altars of your fathers have said you will not pay. Now listen. See the problem. As much as you have not been able to pay, you can never make money in your life up to that amount. Your money, they come in small. You never reached that level before for 7 years. So this is the first time. 500,000 a buck like this.
Wait!
Madam, don't cry. As soon as you return, Madam, what did they do? You know they do anything?
I've been in provision before, but I have stopped it.
You have stopped it? Why did you stop?
Cross of money.
No money. So you know they do anything now. Go and come. I go open business for you.
Can you celebrate Jesus? Can you celebrate Jesus?
Pack the money. This is your first time in handling 500,000. This is the beginning of your wealth.
Hey, nah. Thank you, Jesus.
Listen, Cassie. You cannot encounter this grace. Value this grace well and remain the same. Are they possible? You won't understand. This guy has followed this grace. Who climbs Senka? Cassie, that goes hand in work again. Me, you got email to her. If I think you're not getting more
things, all the necessary. Shake a couple of no more.
today is my day. I didn't imagine what I saw today.
Oh.
Because what I have passed through all these years,
oh,
I couldn't imagine myself being on this level I am.
Oh.
All these years, over 8 years, I'm trying to pay my wife dowry.
Oh.
I'm hustling every day. I know people. I hustle more than my mates. But in vain, I couldn't achieve. I will have business that won't millions. The things will not come. I have tried to pay my wife dowry all these years. Everything is on there. But I really thank God for what God has done today in my life. Using my mother, Prophet Rose Kevin.
Oh.
Today is my happiest day.
Oh.
I couldn't imagine me handling 500,000 naira
oh,
for me to go and pay my wife dowry. I remember 4 years ago when I went to my mother, my father-in-law's place. He insulted me.
Oh.
He called me all sorts of names. Go the sisters, go the daughters, go the sons. I don't have value for them. But now I can boldly walk into the compound and ask them to give me list. Finish my own, and I will even dash them money. Today is the day I will never forget in my life. I didn't believe it will happen today. The God that did it, the God of Prophet Rose Kevin, that did this to me, I will remain loyal to him. I will remain loyal to him. As God did this to me, I will never forget this ministry. Since I located this ministry, I have not gone in other ministry. Since I located this grace, it's working for me. Now my family are happy. Now this is, I can call it beginning of new life. My life has started having meaning. Today is my happiest day. I just want to appreciate what God did in my life.
Mommy, we have this testimony. His name is Ezekiel Edward. See, I am here to share this testimony to the glory of God. Please, if you are Mr. Ezekiel Edward, you are here, just come forward quickly. Mommy gave me some prophecy that I had a business with a close friend, and he went to somewhere to invoke me inside a bottle and also did something concerning my manhood. Sincerely, everything Mommy said that day is true about me. But after that encounter, hallelujah, my manhood has been restored. It's functioning very well.
Your door is about to be open.
Amen.
Things are very tough for you.
Yes.
Eh? Things are very, 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 very tough.
Yes, ma'am.
Eh?
Yes, ma'am.
Can you remember last week? You woke up very early in the morning to urinate. You discover that one part of your body does not have life. Eh?
Yes, ma'am.
Last week.
Yes, ma'am.
Eh?
Yes, ma'am.
This I'm talking about last week, Saturday.
Saturday.
Eh?
Yes,
last week, Saturday.
Yes, ma'am.
You woke up early in the morning to urinate. After urinating, you felt something like as if you were dizzy, as if you wanted to fall. You then discover that one part of your body became lifeless.
My God.
And the thing now is beginning to affect your manhood.
Hey!
Eh?
Yes, ma'am.
Can I pray for you?
Yes, ma'am.
See this one, if I don't pray for him, I see stroke.
Hey! Help him, mommy!
Eh?
Help him, mommy!
I see stroke, oh! Look at stroke, they want to give him. They want to finish this man. Because I see this man inside a bottle. They cock it.
Hey!
He's inside that green bottle.
Jesus!
Are you listening to me, sir?
Okay, listen to mommy.
That is where I see where they kept him.
Hey!
And they cocked that bottle.
My God.
Are you listening to me? Saturday last week. Listen, I am precise about the prophecy.
Yes, ma'am.
Eh?
What happened Saturday?
Eh?
Yes.
That was what happened.
Yes.
Eh?
Yes.
You almost fell.
Yes, ma'am.
But you got hold of something.
Yes, ma'am.
Eh?
Yes, ma'am.
Then you know this woman said that one part of your body, they paralyze. Yes. The thing come also affect your manhood.
Yes, ma'am.
Eh?
Yes, ma'am.
As I'm talking to you now, your manhood they do somehow.
Yes, ma'am.
You know they walk.
Yes, ma'am.
But now you go walk.
Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Praise the living Jesus. I am here to return the glory to God Almighty.
Celebrate Jesus, Father. That testimony remains permanent.
Mommy, this testimony. He said, my name is Mrs. Henrietta Ibuchi. Okay, I came all the way from Lagos. I want to testify to the goodness of God. What God used Mommy, Prophetess Rose Kevin, to do in my family. My daughter was attacked by a satanic power that used to visit her in her dream. And she was also applying for a visa that that should to travel abroad. Now I came about this ministry on Facebook. Then I came to see Prophetess Rose Kelvin, which is my mom in the Lord. So, but before then, my daughter was having dreams where she will be seeing a ghost staring at her through the window parlor. According to her, she ran to tell me about this ghost. Reluctantly, I told her that the ghost was my late grandmother ghost. Now, when I woke up from the dream, now physically, she was now possessed with that demon that used to appear to her in the palace window. Then I was praying with her. I prayed with her just like that, thinking it's an ordinary thing. Now the demon appeared again. I was telling her, you will never travel. If you dare travel out of this country, you will die. Immediately, somehow I had to take a boat step, not minding the roads before getting to Abuja. I came and I encountered mommy one-on-one in the office. And mommy told me what to do. And she gave me some anointing material on how to apply it. On my way going back to Lagos, my daughter called me that the demon ran away from the house and from her life. And to the glory of God, she was also booked for an interview in an embassy. Mommy, after the encounter with you, she went to the embassy. She was given visa without any struggling. And she is here that Friday to give this testimony to the goodness of God. Mommy, this is the proof of the testimony. The visa was given to her without any stress. And that was why she was here to give the testimony.
And she has been looking for a visa for many years.
For many years, mommy.
So after I prayed for her.
Yes, mommy.
The demon left her.
Yes, mommy.
And then today she's free.
She's free, mommy.
And she got the visa.
That's right.
Congratulations to her.
Can you jam your hands together for Jesus?
Mommy, we have a testimony from our international partners. This first testimony is from Mr. Will. From his call to the ministry, he's been in Europe for several years. He said he has been experiencing backwardness in business. Nothing was working. In fact, he was being pitied by the family. And he said, according to his testimony, until the day he saw mommy on Facebook and he encountered that grace, he became one of our partners. And he was privileged to speak with mommy. And he said, few days, mommy said, you will hear a news after this call, few days from now. And he said, it was not up to 3 days. They called him back from Nigeria and said, the stepbrother who was after his life, who apparently was behind his pain and his affliction for several years, suddenly wanted to commit suicide. Hallelujah. Please, let's receive his voice testimony from the studio.
The Lord, I have a testimony. I know that you've started praying for me. We spoke and you said you want to pray for me because the problems I have come from my father's home. And a couple of days into the prayers, one of my half-brothers attempted to commit suicide. He attempted to cut his throat with a knife, and he was stopped. He tried another thing, I don't know what it was, nail, to poke his throat again, and he was stopped, and they carried him to hospital where he, you know, survived. They are now asking us to get money to start looking for what is going on, which I know I don't do anything that is not religious. I will not contribute money for things like that. But I'm just saying that I know that God has started using you to help me save my life from my enemies and from people who are after me for nothing. So I am looking forward for more testimonies, and I will be sending them your way as I receive them, because I know that God is working in this place. Thank you, and may God continue to bless you. My name is Will.
Can you celebrate the King of Kings? Under the grace of my mother, whoever is behind your affliction will be exposed in the name of Jesus. This second testimony is from Ekene DK. He's based in Malaysia. He said, according to his testimony, that he's been in Malaysia for 7 good years with nothing to show. If apparently he was even begging for food, nothing was working in his life until he encountered the oracle in the house. Your life will never remain the same. That amen is not born again. He said as soon as he encountered this grace in the house. One paramount thing that happened in his life is that in that place, nobody builds house. Nobody builds anything. Nobody owns property. The first thing he did, he bought a land in a strategic place in Owerri. And people were calling and saying, we can't believe this. We want to know that prophet. Hallelujah. Studio, please give us his voice.
Mommy, I told me this morning, I'm going to check in number. I'm working at I'm from Imo State. I'm from Mbitoli, local government, Imo State. I've been here in Malaysia over 7 years and nothing to show. So over two months now, I know you, mommy, matrage. So give me a pere me, nisha me pere wam na nange babi any testimony. So anu me any testimony no bochiketa that na chineke ne mene mi him na yoya yotara no bochiketa umonye strala no worry.
Can you chant me the king
one plot of land na nase. So ana me kele chineke na ihe omo mere na me kele kwa gwa na oge omo mi na ihe omo ime kurelem ya wona gbakute m gi ama mi hem na eme no vachin keta na omo nne my family onye obula dey happy ni ihe omo ke chineke mere na omo nne m ni me chineke ana me kele chineke ni ihe omo ko mere masmo ta o shi mere m oge mru ni ana ha Jesus Christ bo onye nwai amen.
Our next testifier is from Mrs. Monica David. She's from India for as a country, but married to a Nigerian man from Anambra, and they are both based in Dubai. She said, according to her testimony, things have been so rough for them, so bad. Even in her office, she's been experiencing endless hatred for no cause. She said, but 2 weeks back, they encountered mommy. They encountered this grace. And mommy spoke a word into their life. She said, the one thing that happened is that she started experiencing favor, promotion, blessing from the office. And the husband had been suffering from high pressure, almost to blindness. And they've booked him for an operation. But she said, after that prayer, they went for another test and they discovered that his eyes were satisfied to be good. Please give us the voice.
Praise the Lord. My name is Mrs. Anita Davidson from India, married to a Nigerian from Anambra State. We stay in the United Arab Emirates. Through Facebook, we started watching Mummy Rose videos. We found it useful. We tried to contact the ministry. Just 2 weeks back, we got the opportunity to become partners of Mummy's ministry. Mummy prayed for us on the phone. After that, we started noticing some changes in our life. Things started moving well. One spectacular thing that happened was my tension in my working place has reduced. I have peace of mind now. I thank God Almighty for Mommy's prayers. Another thing that happened is my husband was having high pressure in both the eyes. He was consulting ophthalmologist. After Mommy's prayer, just after 2 days, he went for a checkup. The doctor and the nurse were surprised. They told it became normal. We believe that it is because of Mummy's prayer. So distance is not a barrier. We give all the glory to God and special thanks to Mummy and her husband for the great work they are doing for mankind. May God continue to shower more grace and anointment. Thank you.
Can you celebrate the King of Kings? If you know you are next for a testimony, jam your hands for the King of Kings.
My name is Uche Onumara. I'm a partnership member. On June, my wife called me and told me that my brother is not feeling fine. I live in Qatar. I live here, I reside in Qatar here. So that my brother is not feeling well, that if I see him, I will not recognize him again. He was so lean. And she asked him, what's the problem? He said he has a tuberculosis, TB. I was like, what will cause this? That he needed some money to go and buy his drugs. Then my wife said she don't have any money here now. They are just managing because I have twins. Things are somehow, since when COVID-19 started, there's a way we do our job here. They will call you on their own time, because when they call you, they will give you whatever they feel like. If you are not satisfied, they can say, okay, if you want to resign, you resign. But that is not my point. So I called my sisters. I say, did you see my brother? I say, my brother is not feeling fine. That they needed to go to hospital and know what is wrong with him. I said, I tell my sister that he come to my house where I left my wife in Lagos. My sister said, okay, that we need to do something. I said, okay, take him to hospital. I send some money. Then they take him to hospital and do some tests and find out that his chest is blocked. The thing has eaten up his lungs. I was like, what will I do? Then I called mommy. I remember that I'm a partnership member. Mama said, you're a partnership of this church. Why not inform the one of God so that she will do something? Because I'm not having any money. I know that his money is involved to send to him. After the test, I call mommy. I cannot reach her. I keep on trying. On 22nd August, I get mommy. I say, mommy, see what I'm passing through. My brother is not feeling fine. He's coughing now. He's coughing and the vomiting blood. After the test, my sister called me that my brother is now vomiting blood. He's coughing seriously, and the landlord said that if there's nobody to come and take care of him, they will send him out. They will call police and send him out, because on that process, as he is coughing and blood, vomiting blood, the wife now run away with the kid. That's okay. I call mommy. Say, see what I'm passing through. Mommy said, you will not lose your brother. I say, amen. He said, right here now, I'm going to do something. Get ready for your testimony. I was like, the spirits enter me. I said, this is what I want to hear. I said, amen. Then he said, send me his name. I will do something here now. I said, okay. I now go off. Send his name. Call my sister. He sent the test of the result of the test. I send it to mommy. The result of the test. I send it to mommy. Then I call mommy again. Mommy said, I told you, you will not lose your brother. I said, okay, because I was panicking. I was like, if this guy died in this Lagos, it's me that will be called. I don't have money to send to carry him or for my place, for my state. Everything is money. So, to my greatest surprise, after 2 days, I called my sister. How far? My sister now said, told me that Mekati has stopped vomiting blood. Say that blood has stopped. Instead, he has stopped vomiting blood. It's no more vomiting blood again. I said, I was like panicking. Is it true or not? I said, okay, tell him, go back to the test again. Go back to the test again and give me the results so that I will know what to do. So they go back to the test, and the test result was like the chest now, the lung that block is now free. He can breathe well, because when they take him to hospital, he cannot talk. He cannot talk. If you talk to him, he just shake his head, because the thing have already eat up his lung. So I give all the glory to God. I thank Money Rose. I thank God for making me locate Money Rose, because Money told me that that is not ordinary. It's a poison. They poison him. But God used Money to rescue my brother. I thank God. That's why I'm giving this testimony today. Thank God for Money Rose. Thank God for me to be a partnership of Money Rose. Thank God for Jesus for making Money Rose heal my brother. I'm so grateful. I cannot stop being a partnership with this church, because God has done good things in my life. Glory be to God.
Can you celebrate the King of Kings? This other testimony is so powerful. It's from our brother Uche Onuma in Qatar. He said that they called him, and his brother was experiencing TB, or he was tested to have TB. And that TB grew to the point that he started coughing out blood and extended to vomiting blood. And when they carried that test, they discovered that he had a blocked lungs. His lungs were blocked. So he was at the point of death. According to the call, he said it was so bad that his wife took off, carried the children, and left him to die, because there was no sign of him being alive. The brother said that he had no money, because they already tell him, prepare for burial. Things were so bad, and there was no even money to send. But he encountered God's oracle. I don't know what is about to die in your life, and you are here. Today, you will go back with your testimony. He said, when he encountered Mommy, Mommy prayed for him and said, your brother will be fine. Nothing will happen to him. When the word comes from the mouth of your prophet, hold it and run with it. That is all you need. He said, after that prayer, 2 days later, a guy that was already considered to be dead, the landlord was already saying they should come and carry him. He doesn't want somebody to die in his house. 2 days later, the blood, the vomiting of blood and the coughing of blood stopped. And they went further to carry out another test. He said, suddenly they discovered that the blocked lungs was now open. Because of grace. Because he encountered the oracle in the house. Can you celebrate grace in the house? Hallelujah. Studio, please give us the voice.
My name is Uche Onoma. I'm a partnership member. On June, my wife called me and told me that my brother is not feeling fine. I live in Qatar. I reside in Qatar here. So that my brother is not feeling well, that if I see him, I will not recognize him again. He was so lean. And she asked him, what's the problem? He said he has a tuberculosis, TB. I was like, what will cause this? That he needed some money to go and buy his drugs. Then my wife said, she don't have any money here now. They are just managing, because I have twins. Things are somehow, since when COVID-19 started, there's a way we do our job here. They will call you on their own time, because when they call you, they will give you whatever they feel like. If you are not satisfied, they can say, okay, if you want to resign, you resign. But that is not my point. So I called my sisters. I say, did you see my brother? I say, my brother is not feeling fine. You know, that they needed to go hospital and know what is wrong with him. I said, I tell my sister that he come to my house where I left my wife in Lagos. My sister said, okay, that we need to do something. I said, okay, take him to hospital. I send some money. Then they take him to hospital and do some tests and find out that his chest is blocked. The thing has eaten up his lungs. I was like, what will I do? Then I called mommy. I remember that I'm a partnership member. My mom said, you're a partnership of this membership of this partnership of this church. Why not inform the one of God so that she will do something? Because I'm not having any money. I know that his money is involved to send to him. After the test, I call mommy. I cannot reach her. I keep on trying. On 22nd August, I get mommy. I say, mommy, see what I'm passing through. My brother is not feeling fine. My brother is not feeling fine. He's coughing now. He's coughing and the vomiting blood. After the test, my sister called me that my brother is now vomiting blood. He's coughing seriously, and the landlord said that if there's nobody to come and take care of him, they will send him out. They will call police and send him out, because on that process, as he is coughing and blood, vomiting blood, the wife now ran away with the kid. That's okay. I call mommy. Say, see what I'm passing through. Mommy said, you will not lose your brother. I say, amen. He said, right here, now, I'm going to do something. Get ready for your testimony. I was like, the spirit enter me. I said, this is what I want to hear. I said, amen. Then he said, send me his name. I will do something here now. I said, okay, I now go off. Send his name, call my sister. He sent the test of the result of the test. I send it to mommy, the result of the test. I send it to mommy. Then I call mommy again. Mommy said, I told you will not lose your brother. I said, okay, because I was panicking. I was like, if this guy died in this Lagos, it's me that will be called. I don't have money to send to carry her, carry him for my place, for my state. Everything is money. So, to my greatest surprise, after 2 days, I called my sister. How far? My sister now told me that Nekati has stopped vomiting blood. Say that blood has stopped. Instead, he has stopped vomiting blood. It's no more vomiting blood again. I said, I was like panicking. Is it true or not? I said, okay, tell him, go back to the test again. Go back to the test again and give me the results so that I will know what to do. So they go back to the test, and the test result was like the chest now, the lung that block is now free. He can breathe well, because when they take him to hospital, he cannot talk. He cannot talk. If you talk to him, he just shake his head, because the thing have already eaten up his lung. So I give all the glory to God. I thank Mommy Rose. I thank God for making me locate Mommy Rose, because Mommy told me that that is not ordinary. It's an poison. They poison him. But God used Mommy to rescue my brother. I thank God. That's why I'm giving this testimony today. Thank God for Mommy Rose. Thank God for me to be a partnership of Mommy Rose. Thank God for Jesus for making Mommy Rose heal my brother. I'm so grateful. I cannot stop being in partnership with this church because God has done good things in my life. Glory be to God.
Can you celebrate the King of Kings? We have a testimony from Roslyn Maderu from Europe. She said she returned back home one of the days and discovered that daughter was in a pool of blood. She had involved in a domestic accident and she broke her nose. And that little baby was in pain. And she said that she was confused. And the only person she could remember was to call mommy and told mommy what happened in the house. And mommy just said a word, "Let the Lord preserve her." That was all mommy said to her. She said, according to the testimony, that the next morning, the little daughter woke up and said, "Mommy, I'm no longer in pain." The pain disappeared because a prophet spoke. Can you celebrate the King of Kings? Hallelujah. Can we have the voice?
My name is Roslyn Maguero. I'm here to testify on the goodness of the Lord. It was last week when I came from town to run some errands. So when I came back at home, it was around 8:30. And I found that my daughter had an accident and she had broken her nose. I really felt so bad as a mother because she was in a lot of pain. Her face was swollen and she could not even eat anything because she also had hurt her mouth. So that night, I was really disturbed because the father was not even there. So I called the father and informed the father, and I told mommy too. Mommy told me one thing, "Let the Lord preserve her." I gained faith on what mommy had told me. The next day, she woke up. She told me she's not in a lot of pain like the previous night. Currently, as I'm talking to you, my daughter is okay. My daughter can eat. My daughter is doing everything. Her nose is okay right now. The swelling has gone. I'm here to testify on the goodness of the Lord and what God has done by using mommy into my life. I'm very grateful for God to use mommy to restore my daughter's health. Thank you.
Can you celebrate the King of Kings? Kechi sent in a testimony from Spain. She said in summary that she came to our office one day and discovered that this a letter of termination was given to her. And she was wondering, why this termination? What have I done? No explanation to that effect. They just told her, "Your services here are no longer needed." So in that pain of heart, she was disturbed. She called mommy. And mommy said to her, "That job is not your job." And she was like, "Mommy," he said, "that job is not your job." And few days and few weeks down the line, she got another job that was well paid. She had a better... So many blessings are tied to that job. That's not just the testimony. She said few weeks later, she ran into one of our colleague in that former office, and she said, "Thank God you left, that everyone in that office has been confirmed COVID-19 and they are all evacuated because she encountered the prophet." Can you celebrate the King of Kings? Please give us the voice.
Lord, my name is Ikechi. I live in Spain. I just want to give God the glory, return glory to God Almighty for preserving me and standing for me and my family. I want to thank God for this great commission. I come across mommy, my husband showed me mommy's video and we are following mommy's video. So I decided to call mommy. I'm a partner, so mommy prayed for us. And so the job my husband was expecting, he didn't reach his hand, they took the job for him. If that is not enough, the one I'm working, they take my job as well to give to somebody. I was like, what is going on? And I called mommy and I said, "Mom, look at what is going on. Mommy said to me, that job is not for me. I say, your own will come. It is where. God bless you. This is only what mommy said. And I was like, I said, okay, I just got the call. I was worried. I said, which one is this job is not for me? This place is a very, because the job is like a job and a business, to, including together. It's a company, you can do your own business inside the company. So I was really worried and I started praying. I said, I said this will be my last bus stop. This is going to be my last bus. I'm not going to any church. I'm not going to any pastor. I'm not calling anybody. This will be my last bus stop. As people is giving testimony, I must give my testimony. So I start praying, and my prayer point is that me and my husband, every night we start praying, we said, they will not have peace until they give me back my job. They will not have peace until they give me back my job. I connect with the grace of my mommy. I connect with the grace of mommy. This is the prayer, this is our prayer point. We are praying, calling God to intervene. So one day I decided, my mind said, let me call my boss. I drop message in my bus, my boss. I said, what is going on? What have I done for you guys to take my position of my work to give to somebody else? So he says to me, I should please have patience, because this situation, this time is somehow, and it's not the only person, a lot of things is going on. I said, please, I want my job back. So I talked to the manager. The manager said, I should hold on, I should have patience. So like 2 weeks again, I decided to call them that my patience is running over. I'm just speaking like the job, the company belongs to me. I don't know, I'm just saying it, you know, out of anger, and but I'm saying it boldly. But if I finish talking, I will say, look at what I'm commanding, talking to these people, you know. So after then, my manager said to me, they are fixing something for me. And that's when my boss said to me, I shouldn't worry, they are doing something special for me. I said, okay. Oh. So one day, they just write to me, I should come to work. And when they said I should come to work, they come to work tomorrow. You need to resume work tomorrow. I said to my husband, I said I should resume work tomorrow. And my husband said, just like that, I said, did they ask? And I'm there. So next day I went to the manager, they came and they say, sorry. They were begging me, asking me, I should sorry for what they did to me. I should temper justice with mercy. I shouldn't be angry. I said, I'm not angry. I said, are you sure? I said, I'm not angry. So I never knew when I came, they called the boss. And then he said, immediately the boss came. He said, are you okay? I said, yes. Please, we are sorry for what we did to you. We are really sorry. I said, Mister, at least my can rest. He said, I couldn't sleep all this while. My mind is beating every time I'm thinking about you. He said, do you like this place? I said, yes, it's okay, it's okay. He said, thank you for coming back to us. Thank you for accepting our proposition. I said, no problem, thank God. So when I saw one of my colleagues, he said, are you here? He said, yes. I said, yes. He said, you are here. I said, yes. He said, thank God. I said, why? He said, the place we are working, they remove us from there. He said, they tested more than 160 people for COVID-19. I said, are you kidding me? He said, yes. I never knew that God just pushed me away before those things. If not, I could have been one of the soldiers, quarantined all of them. So they were calling me. That day, they gave me that information that I shouldn't go to jail. They were calling me to come back, to come and work. I said, no, me, I'm not coming, no. They said, please, I should come back to come and work. I said, no, look, I'm working in another place. So I just want to return glory to God, return adoration. I give all. God, I thank you. Mommy, I thank you so much. I really appreciate. Indeed, there is God. There is God. There is God. I thank everything. I'm happy no matter anything. But what I'm doing, I'm really happy now. It is better than before. Mommy, I will come to see you one-on-one. I'm really, really happy. Mommy, thank you. I enjoy the grace. I tap on the grace. I'm happy. There is a video that YouTube is inside last month. Yeah, a lady who have twins. This lady have twins, and she came to carry that twin. She came to drop 200 naira, and you asked her to pack to come. You call her to come. and asked her where is the husband. She said that the husband is late 1 month before she gave birth to those twins, and you asked her to pack all those money on the floor. I want to give that woman 20,000 for her to manage 20,000 to buy pampers, diapers for the children. So those twins, 20,000. And the widow, she should use 20,000 to buy pampers for the twins. And mommy, please manage the 40,000 to buy chairs. I thank God. I thank God that
Can you charm your hands for the King of Kings?
Verses 8. And it fell on the day that Elisha passed to Shunem, where was a great woman, and she constrained him to eat bread. And so it was that as often as he passed by, he turned in thither to eat bread. And she said unto her husband, behold now, I perceive that this is an holy man of God, which passeth by us continually. Let us make a little chamber, I pray thee, on the wall, and let us set for him there a bed, and a table, and a stool, and a candlestick. And it shall be, when he cometh to us, that he shall turn in thither. And it fell on a day that he came thither, and he turned into the chamber, and lay there. And he said to Gehazi's servant, call the Shunammite. And when he had called her, she stood before him. And he said unto him, say now unto her, behold, thou hast been careful for us with all this care. What is to be done for thee? After today, you will meet a man that will ask you, what can I do for you? Okay. Would does that be spoken for to the king or to the captain of the host? And he answered, I dwell among my own people. And he said, what then is to be done for her? And Gehazi answered, verily she had no child, and her husband is old. And he said, call her. Hey! After today you receive a call. Yes! And when he had called her, she stood by the door. And he said, about this season, according to the time of life, that shall embrace a son. If your amen is louder, you shall be fruitful. Yeah. The best way for a man to accomplish his goals and projects in life is to meet another man that carries the treasure he needs for his manifestation. Am I talking to somebody?
Talk to me, mommy.
I am aware you are aware that it is the Lord that lifts. But God will not come down from heaven and do that. He will have to use a man. It takes a man to make a man. It takes a man to lift a man. It takes a man to establish a man. Even when God wants to remember you as a woman by way of bodily fruitfulness, he will have to use a man. Are you listening to me?
Yes, mommy.
To ejaculate into you, to fertilize an egg. Am I talking to somebody?
Talk to me, mommy.
Am I talking to you?
Talk to me, mommy.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, I want to submit to you, yes, that when an engineer wants to work,
yes,
an engineer works with ionic matters.
I hear you, mommy.
When a doctor wants to work, a doctor works with stethoscope,
yes,
paracetamol, syringe,
yes, mommy,
and all whatnot. Am I talking to somebody?
Talk to me, mommy.
When a tailor wants to work, a tailor works with tape,
that's right,
sewing machine, fabrics,
that's right,
scissors,
that's right,
and all of those. But when God wants to walk, he uses men like you.
I hear you, mommy.
When God was looking for a man to deliver Israel out of Egypt, he found Moses. Am I talking to somebody?
Talk to me, mommy.
He found Moses. When God wanted to bring his son into this world, he found Mary. Am I talking to somebody?
Talk to me, mommy.
When God was looking for a king to rule his people, he found David. Am I talking to somebody?
Talk to
now
me.
Now, in the book of Psalm 89, verses 20, God said, I have found David my servant. And I had to ask, God, was David missing before? And the Spirit of the Lord told me he was hidden somewhere in the bush. God. That his glory should not manifest.
That's right.
But somehow, his glory also found expression. I don't know where they hid you.
God.
That your helpers will not find you. I don't know where they tied you.
Uh-huh.
I don't know where they bottled your star.
My God.
Where they bottled your glory.
My God.
As you are hearing the sound of my voice.
Yes, Lord.
The same way God located David in the bush.
Uh-huh.
Where they kept him.
Yes, Lord.
From today, I relocate you to the front line.
Oh, no.
If your amen is not that, you are relocated to the front line.
Amen.
Every cage where they locked you, I command that cage to be broken.
Amen.
If your amen is not that, you are coming out now.
Amen. Thank you, Jesus.
When Jesus was on his way to crucifixion, Roman soldiers saw a man called Simon Cyrene. They prepared him to carry the cross of Jesus. So even Jesus himself needed someone.
That's right.
To help him carry the cross. So the Roman soldiers prepared Simon Cyrene to carry the cross of Jesus. So now, whether your helpers like it or not,
I hear you, mommy.
Any helper that refuses to help you willingly,
uh-huh,
by force, uh-huh, I command them to help
you. Amen! Thank you, Jesus.
They have refused to do it by choice. They will do it by force.
Amen.
I said they will do it by force.
Amen.
If your amen is louder, they shall do it by force. Oh.
Amen. Thank you, Jesus.
Sit on the head of enemy.
Thank you, mommy.
The children of Jethro, they were always going out to feed their father's flocks. Then, each time they went out, they usually returned very late. Then one day, they went out to feed their father's flock. And the Bible recorded a certain man called Moses helped them to draw water. Hallelujah. And they were able to take care of the flock and return home on time. So when they got home, their father asked them, how come that thou have returned so early today? Many of you let us hear my voice.
Yes, Lord.
After today.
Yes, Lord.
People will ask you, how come your life has suddenly changed?
Amen.
As you are shouting, amen, Jehovah will settle your case.
Amen.
You used to go out before and report empty-handed.
Uh-huh.
But from today.
Yes, Lord.
By virtue of this wonderful service.
Uh-huh.
This prophetic service. This fruitfulness service. Fruitfulness by destiny helpers. May Jehovah send you a man that will make life easy for you. Under 7 days, you shall meet a man that will ask you, what can I do for you? You shall encounter your destiny helper.
Amen.
Encounter financial helper.
Amen.
Encounter business helper.
Amen.
Encounter international helper.
Amen.
Encounter political helper.
Amen.
What is help? Help is a man.
Mm-hmm.
There is no great man. There are no great men. There are only helped men.
I hear you, mommy.
Anybody that tells you I'm a great man is a product of help. There are only helped. Tell me a man, just show me one that is great, that you know, that is not a product of help. A lot of talents and gifts have gone into oblivion. A lot of talents are covered, tied, have not found expression because they lack help. If you don't have helper, you will look like a leper. Any man whose life is void of help will look like a leper.
get it too much. He said, I have been wanting to come and see you, but an enemy stopped me. I have been wanting to come and see you. Anytime your life is devoid of help, it means your destiny is under attack. 1 Thessalonians chapter 2, verse 18. Paul said, over time, I have been wanting to come visit you. I have been wanting to come deliver this parcel to you, but an enemy stopped me. If an enemy can stop Paul, who speaks in tongues, in capital letters, how much more are you? You. How much more are you? An enemy stopped him from going. Right here and right now, wherever your helper is,
yes.
Any restriction,
fire.
Whatever that is stopping your helper,
fire.
From locating and helping you,
fire.
Haya galaba zugada bazagada bana dono mono mago dono bano godo bralaga dosia. Many of you are at the verge of it, but it slips from your hand because an enemy has stopped your helper. As you are hearing the sound of my voice, I remove the blockage.
Amen.
Sit down.
Thank you, mommy.
A certain man was traveling abroad with a white man. A white man promised a certain young man. He said, I am going to take you out of the country. I'm going to help you. You are going to be handling a particular franchise for me in the U.S. Like play. The white man got visa for him. Everything was ready. When they entered the plane, few minutes to take off, the white man died in the plane. And this is somebody that has suffered for so many years. The young man graduated, 10 years no job. He was a cleaner in an hotel. Then suddenly, God sent her a helper. But her enemy said no. Few minutes to taking off, the white man died. Help. God wanted to better his life by way of fruitfulness by destiny helper. But an enemy counteracted and intercepted it. But as you are here right now,
yes, Lord.
Before you leave here today,
yes, Lord.
You shall receive a call that will terminate your insult.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Sit on the head of your enemy.
Thank you, mommy.
A certain young lady who had suitors coming for her. Each time suitors came, suddenly they would decline. Each time suitors came, they would begin to veto. After a while, they now discovered that the compound before theirs, a certain woman there, usually will lay those suitors on the way. You want to marry from that family? They know the bomb Pekino. They know get wumbo. This one they happen. Oh. Then they fight their husband. So she had been doing it over time until one day it was revealed. Anytime somebody wants to marry from that compound, an enemy will lay them on the road. Any enemy that is stopping your helper.
Fire!
That relationship almost landed into marriage. But somehow you didn't know what happened. Because an enemy. An enemy.
My God.
It might not really be spiritual. It might be a close enemy that is speaking ill against you,
friend.
Against your personality.
Mm.
But wherever you are hearing the sound of my voice,
yes, Lord,
it will not be long.
Amen.
Their tongue will cleave to the roof of
the
house.
Amen. Amen.
Your amen is standing on one leg.
Amen.
Sit down.
Thank you, mommy.
The Bible recorded from where we read, Elisha was always passing by Shunem. And then a certain woman, the Bible didn't mention her name, but she was a Shunammite woman. The Bible recorded she was rich. She was rich in cattle, rich in gold. Rich politically, rich socially, but she was barren in the body. Many at times, things may be going well in this area and worse in the other area. She was rich, she was comfortable, she was okay, she could travel to any part of the world. But she was barren in her body. She was barren. She couldn't able to have a child. There are many of you under the sound of my voice. You are sandwiched in between bad times and good times. Sometimes things are all going well in this area. But the other area, things are getting bad and worse. Such were the times that woman went through. People looked at her and felt all was well with her.
Mm.
Until they went closer and discovered that no, it is not what we seem, what it seems.
Mm.
And the Bible recorded that she was shedding secret tears. Many of you are not the sound of my voice. Because of the things you are going through, you've been shedding secret tears. You'll be asking God a question. When will you change my story? When will you remember me? When will I have a child?
My God.
When will I get married?
Mm.
When will I be promoted? When will this untimely death come to an end, my family? Any question you have been asking? Every solution you have been looking for?
Yes, Lord.
Any answer you've been anticipating?
Yes, Lord.
If your amen is louder, it shall enter your hand.
Amen. Thank you, Jesus.
I said, you shall enter your heart.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
She had everything going well with her. Business-wise. Career-wise. Political-wise. Socially. And all of those. But she had this particular one issue in her life. And that was the issue of barrenness. Many of you know the sound of my voice. It might not really be barrenness in terms of having children. It might be barrenness in terms of finance.
I hear you, mommy.
So I don't know the area in which you're experiencing barrenness. As you are hearing me right now.
Yes, Lord.
Barrenness is ostracized from
Amen.
Your life. From your destiny, from your marriage, from your family.
Amen.
If you give me seven amen and one fire, so shall it be.
Amen. 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 Fire.
One thing I know, when God does a thing, the devil can only revolve but cannot dissolve.
You are right, mommy.
Your background is not enough reason for your back to remain on the ground. Micah 7, he said, laugh not at me, oh my enemy, when I fall. For when I fall, I shall rise again.
Hallelujah.
Sons of Solomon chapter 1 verse 6. He said, look not upon me because I am black. The sun has shone on me. That is why my skin is black. Look not upon me because I am black. Sir, na condition na make crayfish bend.
That's right.
Look not upon me because I'm trekking to church now. Look not upon me because I have one suit to wear. Look not upon me because I am not married now. I don't know where they left you before. After today, they will look for you there. They will not find you there again.
Amen.
I said they shall not find you there again.
Amen.
If your amen is louder, they're not going to find you there.
Amen.
Ecclesiastes 9:11, the race is not to the sweet, the battle is not to the strong. Bread is not to the men of gray hair. Riches is not to the men of wisdom. Favor is not to the men of skill. But time and chance happened to them all. If your amen is louder, it is your time.
Amen.
I say it is your time.
Amen.
Isaiah 40:28. Have you no hair? Do you not know? Has it not been told you that the Lord God everlasting King changeth not? Neither is he weary. There is no searching of his understanding. He giveth strength to the weak. To them that have no might, he increases their strength.
Yes,
sir. He said, young man shall fail. Even the youth shall utterly fall. But they that wait upon. I don't know how many years you have been barren. I don't know how many years you've been without a job.
My God.
I don't know how many years you've been without a child.
My God.
I don't know how many years you've been frustrated and stranded. I don't know you're under the sound of my voice.
Yes, Lord.
It is in a state of catastrophe and despondency.
My God.
As you are hearing me right now, God is coming your direction.
Amen.
Amen. Anointing will settle you.
Amen.
Power will settle you.
Amen.
Jehovah will settle you.
Amen.
If your amen is not a carry divine settlement.
Amen. Thank you, Jesus.
Sit on the head of enemy.
Thank you, mommy.
The woman said to her husband, I perceive this man is a real man of God. Perception. How you were perceived determines how you are received. And how you are received determines your result.
I hear you, mommy.
Many of you are beautiful, moving around with a stench.
Hi.
Stench means offensive, repulsive odor.
My God.
Fine girl, educated, but perception about you is always negative. A young man took you to his father's house. He said, Papa, see person I want to marry. Mama, see person I want to marry. He looked, he said, I don't like her. Mama, why? I don't know. I don't just like her.
My God.
Perception. Stench smell. What brings about perception is evil smell. Isaac said to Jacob, he said, behold my son. He said, the smell of my son is like the smell of the field which the Lord has blessed. Perception. The wise men saw the star of Jesus from the east. Perception. What do people say about you? How do people perceive you? Do you look it and not eat? See, I wanted to dash him something about perception. Look at all of you lined up for interview. They choose the people you are even more qualified than. Perception. There's something about him. He's qualified, but his look. I don't like his look. How does he look?
Perception.
How does he look? He's qualified, but you see, he get as he walk. There are people where they walk like this. We are taking you where they walk like this. They say, you get to see the walk. Because
because of the evil smell you are wearing, stench, satanic stench. Yes, so that girl, she's coming from a good home, but there's something about her. What is it about her? I can't explain. Why is it that when they take you to your supposed mother-in-law, she will always reject you? They don't always accept you. Then you can't see person where one don't even go to school. After 1 month, you can't hear say another one. The man they marry. Perception. See, designer's perfume does not eradicate evil smell. If you like, buy Elizabeth Eden. Zoda one. 1 million by Paco Rabin. If you are wearing a stench, an evil stench, your life will even become worse than when you first began. But in this service, your smell will change. Amen. I say your smell will change.
Amen.
Why will you carry your CV? Sophisticated qualification. Then that your CV. They looked at it. They went through it. Say, wow, we can see this is actually what we want in this company. But we'll get back to you. 1 year, they are still getting back to you. 2 years, they are still getting back to you. Sit down, please. 3 years, how can I get back to you? For how long will you continue like this? For how long? But I hear the Lord said to me, before you walk out of that exit door,
yes, Lord,
your story will change.
Amen.
I said, story will change, your story will change.
Amen. Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Now, what I realized about Vashti's story, Vashti didn't have a helper. If a helper had spoken on her behalf, she wouldn't have been dethroned. Many of you are stranded today because you have nobody speaking for you.
That's right.
They say, before you go there, you must get long leg. See, some people are in prison for what they know nothing about.
That's right.
They are in prison because nobody, no helper, has solicited on their behalf. They say, before you come out from that place, now long leg. Now listen. Scientists made us to understand by way of research, the distance between heaven and earth is about 33 million miles.
That's right.
Now, the earth is of the Lord and the fullness thereof.
That's right.
Heaven, his throne. Earth, his footstool. So, if heaven is his throne, earth, his footstool, that means God's leg is as long as 33 million miles.
Talk to me, mommy.
Yes. See, now people will get a long leg. How long is your leg? Whose leg is longer than normal? So if they have a long leg, your God's leg is as long as 33 million miles. Therefore, wherever they have spoken against you, wherever you need divine intervention,
Jesus,
which your physical leg cannot get to,
yes, Lord,
your ghost leg, uh-huh, that is as long as 33 million miles, uh-huh, will invade that place now.
Amen. speak.
I prophesy to you.
I receive.
Where your voice cannot reach.
Jesus.
Yes, Lord.
Your God's voice will get there.
Amen.
Where your hands could not get to. Your God's hand will get there.
Amen.
If your amen is not a carry divine intervention.
Amen.
Sit on the head of your enemy.
Thank you, mommy.
By way of perception, Vashti's flippant miniature disposition was perceived as rebellion. What did she do? Go call my wife, let her come and dance. Honey, I'm tired today. Can you hear Vashti? Call Vashti, call my wife. King Ahasuerus told them, say, go and call her. Let her come and showcase her beauty to the world. Let them know how beautiful my wife is. They went to call her. He said, call my wife. Let her come and showcase her beauty to the world. Vashti said, honey, tell my husband I am a little bit tired. I'm depleted today. Maybe next time. Who knew if she was having a running stomach? Uh-huh. Or they were migraine. That day wasn't just okay for her to dance as usual. Now they went back and told the king, your wife has disobeyed you. They magnified the case. Problem expanders. Problem expander.
Hi.
Just little thing where this woman talk. Say, tell my husband, say, I'm tired. Just tell him that. I'm just weak. They went and gave the king a different story. Your wife disobeyed you. King, our wives will follow suit. If we don't do anything about this case, our wives will start disrespecting us. Because the queen has disobeyed the king. Who said so? Memucan. Memucan. The problem expander. Somebody told his wife, honey, I need toothpick after eating. He said, honey, give me toothpick. The woman said, toothpick, don't finish. The man said, I don't marry again. He said, no! I am not getting married to you again. The next thing, divorce. Problem expander. So Vashti lacked the voice of a helper. So the voice of her enemy prevailed. Memucan said, who knew if Memucan had not even asked her out and she refused?
It's possible.
Hey.
Talk to me, mommy.
Probably Memucan had wanted to touch her one day because Memucan is very close to the king. Memucan is, will I say, the king's voice. Anything where you take king. No, Memucan, I'm talking about. Memucan! So probably Memucan, and she refused. And then he wanted to get back to her, at her. And that was how Vashti was dethroned. And nobody spoke for her. There are many of you that are going through in your various marriages because there is no voice. No voice of a helper. Your husband's people look at your elder brother and say nothing. He's an abaro pusher. What can he do?
My God.
He looked at papa, papa don't die. Mama, nothing. Your siblings, nothing to write him about. He's making decisions, landmark decisions that are affecting you emotionally and otherwise.
My God.
Because there is no voice to speak for you. After today, Jehovah will speak for you.
Amen.
El Shaddai will speak for you.
Amen.
Lion of Judah will speak for you.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Sit down.
Thank you, mommy.
A certain man had two boys. The two boys were doing well all of a sudden. The brother crippled them. One became mad. One became useless, like somehow like an imbecile. One day they were quarreling. His younger brother slapped him. Pah! The man looked at his two sons. Nobody to intervene. The other one was mad. The other one was Imege Imbe. He looked up and said, "Oh God. Oh God." He wept. So, if this man's children, we are able. Younger brother. He had looked around, nobody to fight for the man. Somebody pointed at a young boy's mother's face. He said, "What can you do? What can your children do?" He said, "What go me go? There are many of you that people are about to put their hands, their fingers into your mother's heart because they feel you have no voice."
I hear you, mommy.
Confiscating land and properties because they feel you people have no voice. But I hear the Lord said to me,
"Yes, Lord.
God will send you people a pillar that will stand as a help."
Hey,
amen. The pillar that is required to bring you people out of shame.
Yes.
You will see that pillar.
Hey, amen.
If your amen is louder, your helper is coming.
Amen.
The voice of your enemies will no longer prevail.
Amen.
Genesis chapter 3 verse 10. God appeared in the garden. By the heat of the day. He called Adam. He said, "Adam, where are thou?" Adam said, "We hid because we were naked." But before then, Adam said, "We heard your voice walking." How can a voice walk? He said, "We heard your voice walking in the garden, then we hid." He didn't say, "We saw you coming." Mm-hmm. Or, "We heard your footstep." But Adam said, "We heard your voice walking in the garden, then we hid." That suggests to me that a voice is an entity.
I hear you, mommy. I hear that one.
A voice is a personality.
Uh-huh.
You might not be seeing the person, but somebody has spoken a word that is operational in your life. Somebody looked at you and said, "You can't be married." It became a walking voice. It's an entity. He said, "Unless I not be chief, so, everybody will begin to die in this family." 1 year later, people began to die. The walking voice. He said, "You'll be 50, 60, no marriage. Come marry, make I sick." Person look you, talk to you, tell you this thing. Now you are 35, 36, 37, 40. No man. The walking voice. A voice is an entity. Hello, ma. A voice is a personality.
I hear you, mommy.
Even cause na personality is an entity. Can I prophesy?
Prophesy, mommy.
Every voice crying from the pit of hell.
Fire!
Released from the altars of your father's house.
Fire!
Released by a man, by a woman.
Fire!
And it looks as if that cause has permeated through your life.
Hey!
And has found expression into your life.
My God!
If your amen is louder, that voice shall be silent.
Hey!
I command the voice to be silenced.
Amen.
Anytime God speaks, every other voice becomes a noisemaker.
Oh, yes.
Who is it that saith and it cometh to pass? When the Lord is not in attunement. I prophesy.
I receive.
After today.
Yes.
Every curse on your life is broken.
Amen.
Limitation is broken.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Sit on the head of your enemy.
Thank you, mommy.
The destiny of every David requires a Samuel. The destiny of every Elisha requires an Elijah.
Yes, ma'am.
The destiny of every Ruth requires a Boaz. The destiny of every Mephibosheth requires a Ziba. Hey, I am looking for somebody that will do this for me. I'm looking for somebody that can that can play for me. I'm looking for someone that can woman of God, do you know anybody that does build, maybe an engineer, a good engineer? If I know you as an engineer, I know you as an engineer, but by way of perception, by way of perception, your character doesn't resonate with mine. Do you think I'm going to recommend you to someone?
No.
That is how it works. See, God will not come down from heaven and help you.
I hear you, mommy.
David asked, is there anyone in the house of Saul that I may show kindness for Jonathan's sake? A certain man rose up and said, his name was Ziba. He said, there is one remaining. That one is in Lodiba. That one on village, on village. Nkahon, Ogahon school. King, forget about that one. But if you still want to help him, you can help him because he's from Jonathan's loins. You can still help him. But you didn't go to school. I don't know if you're looking for a PA. A secretary. I don't know what you're looking for, actually. But he can't fit in. You know, go to school. He's crippled. Okay, he's GM. Now, whether you are qualified or not, whether you have the qualification or not.
Yes.
Yes, Lord.
But because the king has remembered it today.
Amen.
You will get what you are looking for.
Amen.
Thank you, Jesus.
Sit.
Thank you, mommy.
The king asked to fetch Mephi. When Mephi came, the king looked at Mephibosheth and said to him, whether you went to school or not, I care less to know whether you are qualified to be in this kingdom or not. I care less to know whether you are crippled or not. But because I have remembered the house of Jonathan, you shall eat with the king. Now, Mephibosheth that was crippled, when he began to eat with the king on the dining, the dining table hid his deformity. People came, greeted the king, also greeted him, greeted Mephibosheth.
Hey!
The same people couldn't recognize him.
My God.
Ay, 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 ay,
hallelujah.
You that men have given up on. Men have written you. They say nothing good can ever come out of you. But I see the rejected stone becoming the chief cornerstone from
God. Amen.
If you shout amen, the rejected stone shall become the chief cornerstone.
Amen.
If your amen is not that, Jehovah will settle you now.
Amen.
Sit on the head of your enemy.
Thank you, mommy.
Now this woman decided to honor the prophet. Listen, anytime you see honor, 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 so that honor will honor you.
That's right.
If you don't honor, honor, honor will not honor you. And honor will not gravitate towards you.
I hear you, mommy.
She said to her husband, let us make him a house at the upper room. That is penthouse of our time. I mean, you know what it means, penthouse? Eh? I think a man a penthouse. She understood that you are not supposed to despise an anointing. Every anointing you value is supposed to be above you.
That's right.
So that anointing can cover you.
That's right.
Let's make room up, not down. Any anointing you despise cannot lubricate your destiny. He's a merciful God. He's also a consuming fire.
That's right. I hear you, mommy.
He's the lamb and also the lion of the tribe of Judah. Don't joke with the oil that has the capacity to make you. No matter how wise you think you are, you can't be wiser than God.
That's right.
Are you really wise? Any anointing you despise cannot help you. If you come here with doubt, you go empty-handed. There are two things which you can't escape from every anointing. Number one is cost. Number two is the blessing.
That's right. I hear you, mommy.
You can't escape these two.
That's right.
No anointing keeps you neutral. It's either it blesses you, it might not really cost you. You will attract the cost.
Mm-hmm. That's right.
The anointing might not necessarily say, God punish you, God, dude, you would fail. No. The anointing might not even notice you.
That's right.
But it sees you.
I hear you, mommy.
No anointing leaves you like that. It blesses and it curses.
That's right.
If you believe from your heart and you are here to seek God.
Yes, Lord.
If you stand up and shout, oh God, remember me, you will find God.
Oh God, remember me.
Shout it again.
Oh God, remember me.
Shout it again.
Oh God, remember me.
She said, let us build house. Let's prepare a house at the upper, not down. Let's furnish it. Let's put table. Let's put chair. Let's put television. Let's furnish the place for the prophet so that he can be able to have comfort. See, anything you do for your pastor and you expect pastor's reward, actually, then that thing might not really bless you, actually.
That's right.
This woman didn't say, let me see whether I will have children after doing this. The Bible recorded that the woman called the husband. The same way that Shunammite woman was discussing how to help a man of God. That is how people will gather to talk about how to lift you.
Amen. Amen.
Helpers will converge. What are we going to do to make this man a better person? What are we going to do to give this person the contract? Amen. What are we going? They are going to be signing. Aya bala bala bala. If your amen is louder, they shall gather to discuss how to favor you. They shall gather to discuss how to lift you.
Amen.
If your amen is louder, your helper will discuss about you.
Amen.
Your helper will discuss about you.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
The hand of Zerubbabel has started it. His hand will accomplish it.
Amen.
Whatever your hands started this year.
Yes, Lord.
That looks as if it is dribbling now. Between now and December.
Yes, Lord.
Your hand shall finish it.
Amen.
Your hand will finish it.
Amen.
Your hand will actualize it.
Amen.
Your hand will complete it.
Amen.
If your ever is there, it shall be completed.
Amen.
Amen.
It's possible you started this year empty.
Uh-huh.
It's possible you started in a miniature kind of way.
Yes, Lord.
But I hear the Lord said to me.
Yes, Lord.
Before the end of this year.
Uh-huh.
Amen.
You go finish well.
Amen.
Receive the anointing to finish well.
Amen.
Receive the grace of a good finisher.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
If your amen is louder, you shall actualize.
Amen.
Jeremiah 35. Sit down.
Thank you, mommy.
Now, the woman said, let's build house up. In Jeremiah 35, the children of Rechabites, their forefathers told them, you shall not build. From where we read now, the woman said, let's build house for this man up. Let's make room up. But in Jeremiah 35, the children of Rechabites,
Their fathers told them, all of you, for this kindred, thou shall not lay a block. Thou shall not build house. You shall remain in tent. You shall remain a tenant. Somebody shall God forbid.
God forbid.
Fathers leave will for their children. But this one left bill and debt. You see? But how wicked that man was. That man must be a strong wizard. Enemy of progress. Even to your own children. He said, nobody should build house. You must live in the house where other people build. For what? There will be no money. Don't have money to build house. You will remain a tenant.
God.
Even in the village, in the city, you will not build.
My God.
That was what their fathers told them. He said, thou shalt not drink wine. Wine represents celebration. In other words, no marriage. Nobody in this family should marry. Wine also represents child education. Even if you escape it, you cannot have a child. That is a working voice. And that voice, even when they died, the voice lived from generation to generation until God got angry and sent prophet Jeremiah. He said, go! Give them wine, let them drink. In other words, let them go and get married. Even when the prophet came and said, the Lord said I should give you wine. In other words, you will be getting married. They said, our fathers told us not to drink wine. They told us not to marry. They told us not to have children. They told, oh my God. Every generational curse.
Fire!
Ancestral curse.
Fire!
Ancestral voice.
Fire!
Foundational curse.
Fire!
Foundational voice.
Fire!
Speaking against your mother's children.
Fire!
That is operational in your foundation.
Fire!
Every foundational error.
Fire!
If your amen is done, that error shall be corrected.
Yeah.
Somebody shout, it shall be corrected.
It shall be corrected.
Shout it again.
He shall be corrected.
Shout it again.
He shall be corrected.
Shout it for the last time.
He shall be corrected.
As I'm talking to you now, your father's house can hear me.
Yes, Lord.
That Hiroko can hear me.
Loud.
That thing where they bury for your papa come back, he can hear me.
Yes.
Your stepmother can hear me. Your wicked uncle can hear the sound of my voice.
Yes.
Wherever they are that have turned your glory.
Fire.
Wherever they are that held your destiny to ransom.
Fire.
As they sleep today's night, they will not wake up tomorrow.
Amen.
Sit on the head of your enemy.
Thank you, mommy.
Enough is enough. Enough is enough. Your life will not remain the same after now.
Amen.
Because you have come to seek God, you will find God here.
Amen.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
The woman called the husband and they made room for him. Each time he passed for crusade, he go land there. Relax, drink cold water, eat good food. One day, Elisha sent his servant Gehazi. He said, I want to know what this woman lacks. What does she desire of the Lord? Gehazi told Prophet Elisha, she has no child. And her husband is old. In the timing of men, it is impossible. But when the Lord shall turn again, the captivity, yabalaga yadabaladaba. It might not be possible to you or for you. It might look impossible for you. But I hear the Lord say to me, every impossibility in your life, whatever you had looked at and said, no, this one is a no-go area,
after today, it shall be a walkway for you.
Amen.
Every impossibility shall be made possible.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Sit down. Ladies and gentlemen, the Bible recorded. Elisha told Gehazi, bring the woman. She doesn't have a child. Bring her. Like I told you, no anointing leaves you like that. I'm talking about genuine anointing.
That's right.
No be people where they anoint private part, anoint breast. I know what I'm saying. Genuine anointing. No genuine anointing leaves you the same. It's a, because every anointing wants to release something. Every anointing wants to discharge and unleash. He said, she has no child, but the husband is old. Now, Gehazi was talking from the perspective of woman. From human perspective. He said, but the husband is old. In other words, she might not be able to conceive. Even though I know you are a prophet. When Elijah was praying, he said, one of his servants said, check whether it's about to rain. Eh? The servant checked. He said, I got nothing. He prayed, put his head in between his knee. He prayed, calabagat, the sweat. He said them again. He said, I got nothing. No. He said, go check again. The third time. He said, nothing. For your mind, he said, make I finish this prayer. How can I be praying and be sweating? He said, you don't see anything. This double portion, I won't give it to you. You don't give him encouragement at all. That was why you don't give him the double portion. You can't give him Elisha. You are meant to encourage your prophet. Can't you see how Gehazi ended? He tell him, say, but the husband is old. Enemies of progress. They want to discourage you. That anointing where you get, make you not to explore. So that they will dampen your spirit. Forget people. Gehazi, see how he ended. He said to Elisha, he said, the husband is old. She has not bought, the husband is old. Why tell him that area? Even though he knew that God can still use him. He said, go and check. Because I hear the sound of abundance of rain. He said, go and check whether the cloud has changed. He said, I don't see anything, no. You go the first one, go the second one, go the third one, go the fourth one, go the fifth one. I can imagine Elijah. Say, Elijah, say, for your mind. You see double this double portion where they look for. You are frustrating me. It's possible he saw, but he won't make you sweat more. Yeah, so it's possible is Elijah, go and check for me. I eat a break. God had already told him. He was aware. But he said, he said, check here, I'm glad to make somehow. I said, I want to check, but I want to check. For him, I said, pray more. Sweat. Fast. You know? People are wicked. Now, so he pray. The sixth one, he saw a guy. People said, this is not the work. He said, still go and check. In my now he can't conclude. I see. Because he's already tired. If he still had the strength to still be going, if I go 20 times. Because he said, she has no child, but the husband is old. Elisha not even looking face. He said, call her for me. You not even like have doubts within him. Since this man is old, what you go do now? He said, bring the woman. They fetch the woman. Elisha said to the woman, by this time, I am talking to you now. By this time, December. By this
Lord.
What you could not achieve in the past 5 years,
Jesus,
you shall achieve it. You shall achieve it. You shall achieve it. You shall carry it. What January to this time could not give to you, between now and December,
yes, Lord,
you go in presser. What they said you will not have, you shall have it. What your fathers could not do, you shall do. Where your fathers could not get to, you shall get there. If your amen is Lord, I receive fruitfulness. Put your two hands on your head. Shout out God.
Oh God.
Shout out God.
Oh God.
Shout out God.
Oh God.
By fruitfulness, by destiny helper.
By fruitfulness, by destiny helper.
Remember me and send me help.
Remember me and
open
send
your mouth and fire prayer.
Shabataka lekatu lebeledia. Mante lekata by fruitfulness. Fruitfulness by destiny helpers. Rakoto mida deba.
Hallelujah.